Hello learners, my name is Mayur Bhagarwal. In today's lecture, we are going to study profit, nature, concepts and theories of profit. So let us start with the meaning part of profit. Profit is the factor income attributed to entrepreneur. The main function of an entrepreneur is to bear uncertainties or take risk. Income that an entrepreneur get is in return for these factors is called profit. According to Jacob Osser, profit is the residual income of business after all explicit and implicit wages, interest and rent has been met. According to Henry Gacron, profit may be considered as a reward for making uncertainties, a reward for accepting risk and uncertainties and market imperfections. Profit is the earning of an entrepreneur. To the economist, the most significant point about profit is that it is residual income. However, the term profit has different meaning. In short, the following are the distinct features of profit as a factor income or a factor reward. It is not a predetermined contractual payment. It is not a fixed remuneration. It is residual surplus. It is uncertain, it may be negative. Let us discuss all these points in detail. The first point is, it is not a predetermined or contractual payment as we are having different factors of production like labor. For labor we are paying wages and for capital we are paying a fixed rate of interest. But when we are talking about an entrepreneur, he is getting profit as a reward whatever he is applying for the organization. It is not predetermined that he will get a fixed rate of income from the income. It is not fixed. The second point is, it is not fixed remuneration. As we have discussed that the entrepreneur is not getting a fixed remuneration like an employee. He is an employer. He is not having a fixed rate of income. The third point is, it is a residual surplus. Residual surplus means the last part of revenues which are left after paying all the expenses will be get to the entrepreneur. It means that whatever the expenses are there in an organization being paid by an entrepreneur, after paying all the expenses, whatever been left is the part of it is for the entrepreneur. It is uncertain. The next point is, it is uncertain. Uncertain means it is not fixed that it will get the same remuneration every year or every month. It will be fluctuating. It may be positive or it may be negative. Mainly, profit has been divided into two parts, that is gross profit and net profit. Gross profit, it refers to the difference between the total revenue of a firm and its total explicit cost. Gross profit is the profit a business makes after subtracting all the costs that are residual, that are restricted to manufacturing and selling its product and services. We can get gross profit by total revenue minus explicit cost. Let us discuss this formula in detail. The total revenue means the total amount of money which we are generating after making all the sales. We are getting suppose that we are getting 1 lakh rupees in revenue. And explicit cost means so many costs. Suppose that we are having manufacturing cost, we are purchasing raw material, paying labor to the wages. So after deducting all the explicit cost which are seeing in the organization, which we are recorded in the accounts, are comes under explicit cost. After deducting this, we get gross profit. The constituents of gross profit are interest on entrepreneur's own capital, wages of entrepreneur's own labor, rent on entrepreneur own land, depreciation charges, insurance charges, and next the economic or pure or net profit. लेट अस डिस्कस नेट प्रॉफिट और इकोनॉमिक प्रॉफिट. नेट प्रॉफिट इज द एक्सक्लूसिव रिवॉर्ड फॉर द एंटरप्रेन्योर फॉर द फॉलोइंग फंक्शंस परफॉर्म्ड बाय हिम. और वी कैन से दैट इट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द रेवेन्यू एंड टोटल कॉस्ट बाय प्रॉफिट. इन इकोनॉमिक्स वी मीन नेट प्रॉफिट और इकोनॉमिक प्रॉफिट और प्योर प्रॉफिट. इट इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय इम्प्लिसिट कॉस्ट. It is calculated by implicit cost, depreciation charges, and insurance charges, etc. from the gross profit. We can calculate net profit or economic profit by total revenue minus total cost. Total cost include implicit cost plus explicit cost. Or we can also calculate economic profit by gross profit minus implicit cost. Implicit cost. The constituents of implicit cost are reward for taking risk, reward for bearing uncertainties, reward for abilities, monopoly gain, windfall gains, and reward for innovations. These are the constituents which an entrepreneur take and get reward in regard of profit. So let us discuss the difference between accounting profit and economic profit. An accounting profit looks at profit as a surplus or revenue over cost as recorded in the books of accounts. An accountant is interested in accounting, auditing, planning and budgeting profit. Accountant does not take care of implicit or opportunity cost. Accounting profit is also called residual profit. Whereas when we are talking about economic profit, the economist, however, does not agree with the accountant's approach to profit. The accountant would only be deduct the explicit or actual cost from the revenue to determine the profit. The economist point out that in addition to the deduction of explicit cost, implicit cost, that is the cost that would have been incurred in the absence of employment of self-owned factors should also be deducted. So now let us discuss the different theories being propounded by different authors. Let us discuss all these theories in detail. The theories are as follows: risk theory of profit, uncertainty bearing theories of profit, dynamic theory of profit, innovation theory of profit. Let us discuss all these theories in detail. The first theory is risk theory of profit. Risk theory of profit was propounded by J.B. Helway. This theory regards risk taking as a main function of the entrepreneur. The entrepreneur coordinates with other factors of production like capital, labor, land, etc. and initiate production. According to Helway, there is proportional relationship between or a direct relationship between profit and risk. Higher the risk of the entrepreneur, greater will be the profit, or vice versa. According to Helway, an entrepreneur may have to bear four kinds of risk. That is replacement risk. Second one is proper risk, uncertainty risk, and obsolescence. These are the risks for which an entrepreneur gets profit as a reward. The next theory is uncertainty bearing theory of profit. According to the Frank S. Knight, the main function of an entrepreneur is to bear all uncertainties related to production. Profit is a reward for bearing uncertainties. Profit is a reward for bearing uninsurable future uncertainties. Profit is concerned exclusively with uncertainty bearing. Business risk can be of two types, that is certain risk and uncertain risk. Certain risk. There are risks which can be insurable. These refers to the theft, accident, fire, etc. Every entrepreneur can foresee them and can get rid from these. Can get rid from them by means of insurance. Payment of insurance premium with regard to the risk form the part of cost of production. Whereas when we are talking about uncertainty risk, according to Knight, an entrepreneur has to bear several kind of uncertainty risk which can be foreseen or uninsured again. These risks alone give rise to profit. Uncertainty risk include uncertainties in market condition, Next condition is competitive uncertainties, government interference, technological innovations, and business cycle. These are the uncertainties, risk which an entrepreneur cannot get insured of. According to Knight, an entrepreneur will get profit only when he will have uncertainty risk or cure about uncertainty risk. The next theory is dynamic theory of profit. This theory was propounded by J.B. Clark. According to him, profit is a dynamic surplus that arises only under dynamic condition. That is, no profit under static condition. Profit arises because of the difference between the selling cost and its cost of production. Under static condition, there is no change in economic factors like demand, supply, size of population, etc. There is no risk or uncertainty to be faced by an entrepreneur under static conditions. Every factor of production get reward equal to its marginal productivity. Entrepreneur get normal profit. According to J.B. Clark, competitive static situation is found in real life. In this situation, five generic changes are going, or we can say that these five changes can have an entrepreneur to get a profit. These are as follows: change in the quantity or quality demanded due to change in population, change in the pattern of demand, change in production, change in techniques of production, change in quantity of capital, change in the form of business organization. The next theory is innovation theory of profit. Innovation theory of profit was propounded by Stampeter. According to this theory, the function of an entrepreneur is to introduce innovations or new incentives. Rewards that an entrepreneur get from innovation is called profit. All these innovations and changes due to which cost of production can be reduced or average revenue can be increased, or the difference between revenue and cost can be enlarged, are called innovations. According to Stampeter, innovations are of five kinds. The first one is introduction of new product. Next one is introduction of new methods of production, opening up of new market, discovery of new sources of raw material. The last one is recognition of an industry. These are the point through which an entrepreneur gets profit in the when he will do innovation in this form, he will get profit, according to Stampeter. Let us discuss all these point in detail. The first one is introduction of new product. As we can have existing product in the market, suppose that we are producing soap in the market. The soap is having new features, then only he will sustain in the market. Or in the long run, if we will having the same product in the long run, thus the product will be copied by the other producers, so we will have only normal profit. According to Stampeter, we'll have to innovate new product in the market to get the profit from the market. According to this theory, profit due to innovation is temporary because other entrepreneur imitate the innovation. Competition among the entrepreneur grows and thus economic profit disappears. The greed of profit ensures entrepreneurs to go in for more innovations. Thus, innovation gives rise to profit, and greed of profit stimulates entrepreneurs to innovate. So these are the theories of profit. Thank you.